It is defined as the ratio of height of an image to the height of an object. So, ratio of height of an image to the height of an object. I am just rubbing this. I need this equation, that's why I am not touching it. So, by definition, M is equal to A dash B dash over AB with minus sign. A dash B dash over AB value we have already calculated. So, when you put minus here, you will get magnification is equal to minus B dash C over BC. What is B dash C? B. What is BC? Minus U. So M is equal to V over U. Use this relation using Lenz formula. What is Lenz formula? 1 over F is equal to 1 over B minus 1 over U. Multiply both the sides with B. What you will obtain? V over F is equal to 1 minus V over U. Get the value of V over U from there. So, V over U is equal to 1 minus V over F. Therefore, M can also be written as 1 minus V over F. Right? If final distance or image is formed at least distance of distinct vision, for image at least distance of distinct vision, that is D is equal to 25 centimeter. It is a distance up to which a normal eye can see, observe without any stress. So V is equal to minus D, but here it is plus D only. So you can have M is equal to 1 plus 1 minus D over F. So depending upon the situation, if image is virtual and from this side, same side of an object, then it will be 1 plus DF. This is all about Lenz formula. Now I am going to tell you what is power of lens. You know that lens does only two things. Either it converts the light radiation falling on it, or it diverts the light radiation falling on it. So power of lens is actually the measure of ability to convert or divert for a given lens. Right? To convert or divert a given lens. Mathematically, we can calculate as reciprocal of focal length. So SI unit is meter inverse or diopter. Fine. If you want to define one diopter, then you can easily define. The power of lens is said to be one diopter if its focal length is 1 meter. I repeat, the power of lens is said to be one diopter when its focal length is 1 meter. Let us calculate what will be the power and focal length of combination of lens. So going to talk about combination of lens. This is one lens, I kept it here. This is principal axis. This is optical center of first lens. Fine. This is point object. The ray of light coming and falling on this lens, this gets refracted, say here, I dash. When you combine and place another lens L2 in contact with it, optical center, this is L1, L2, the ray of light will converge more. So final image is formed at I dash. This is U, this is final image is formed at I, this is V. This we can mark it as V dash. V dash is the position of image formed by the first lens L1. So apply lens formula 2 times. What is lens formula again? 1 over F is equal to 1 over V minus 1 over U. Applying for L1. Applying for lens L1. You can write 1 over F1. Is equal to 1 over V dash minus 1 over U. Assuming F1 and F2 are the focal length of lens, is L1 as focal length F1, L2 as focal length F2. Applying same formula for lens L2. Then 1 over F2 will be equal to 1 over V minus 1 over V dash. In fact, for the second lens, the image formed by the first lens at I dash, it acts as virtual object for this lens. And final image is formed at I. Add these two equations. On adding these two equations, you will get 1 over F1 plus 1 over F2 is equal to 1 over V minus 1 over U, and that is 1 over F. So your final formula is 1 over F is equal to 1 over F1 plus 1 over F2, where capital F is focal length of combined lens. Combined lens. And 1 over F is defined as power. So power of combination you can say P is equal to P1 plus P2 and so on.